Hello, I'm Mr. R. Nidja, a retired lecturer of metallurgy preaching Christianity and Sikhism. I did some video. I think the IDO is missing, so I'm repeating this one. This is the Oxford Theologian, Men of Letters, drunk with the old wine of the letters, desiring not the new. So I went to visit Oxford University on 2nd December. And there was a seminar on synoptic gospel in the ARCO Building of the Keble College, and I attended it. Fortunately, it was open to all. So there were highly qualified professors in theology, around 50 to 60, you know, and I was with my Hoody t-shirt that been printed with that logos, having logos stressing John the Baptist, why he did not baptize a woman or a Gentile, but only the Jewish men, sensible Jewish men. So I put that on and to just show them, and the men of letters there were, they were looking at my hoodies, logos, reading it, but not asking any question in case, you know, if they ask some silly question and they cut a sorry finger. So, I just, So I just, you know, well, sat down in on the front seat. And a man, there was a man professor who was sitting behind me, and he said, are you a Gnostic? I said, yes, I am a Gnostic. And then he started chatting, you know, about the Gospel of St. Thomas. And I told him he was Christ Thomas, but it did not strike him, you know, much. So then I explained to him the last saying of Christ Thomas: unless a female becomes a male, she cannot enter into the royal kingdom of God. Oh yes, I've known that, heard that one. But I asked him, you know how to, how a female becomes a male? No idea. Then I just in a short message said, you know, when you are an independent thinker, when you are a solitary, his word is a double-edged sword that make you solitary. And Jesus himself was solitary. He made other people solitary. So that's what we are to do. We are solitary. We make other people solitary. And when a person is a solitary, as in John 9, the born blind person whose eyes Jesus opened with spittle. Remember, spittle comes from the mouth. Whosoever drinketh from the mouth of Christ Jesus become like him. So he opened the eyes with the spittle, and the man was solitary. He wasn't asking his parents what to say, or asking the rabbis what he should say from his mouth, but he was independent thinker. Independently he gave the answer. So such person is called solitary or virgin. So a person sitting behind me was a professor from an American university, and he did ask me whether I was a Gnostic. I told him so, and to engage him in discussion, mentioned the last saying of Christ Thomas: unless a female becomes a male, she cannot enter into the royal kingdom of God. But he felt not to engage himself in discussion, and even some people I knew on my previous visit to their church. I went to their church, you know, one evening just by chance and met a few people, and even they were not, you know, trying to speak with me, were not interested in talking in case the other may take them for a heretic, as well. I was amused how they tried to compare the sayings of Jesus in the four Gospels, beating the bush or burying their dead in letters. Everybody except me was very keenly listening, while I knew the dead values of their research in letters. It was good rubbing shoulders with the university dons in theology. Oxford is a well-known theological center, and I hope to meet them again, as the Oxford University is an authority in theology. Poor men of letters are drunk with the old wine of the letter, desiring not the new. And empty they came into the word, and empty will they return. So, people like Jerusalem, when Jesus used to go to Jerusalem, there were people drunk with the old letters of the Torah. So when Jesus wanted to talk to them, they would not listen to him. They would call, "Hey, this man is a crazy man. Something wrong with his head." And they were talking about Messiah. And when Jesus said, "What about the one standing in front of you?" And they have no idea, that he is the Christ. Now these men in Jerusalem, they were men of letters. Whereas the Samaritan woman at the well in John 4, she was a woman of spirit. So in spirit, she engaged Jesus into deep, deep discussion and then identified him that you are a prophet. She evaluated him. But those people in Jerusalem could not. So same was the situation here. These university professors, they were drunk with the old wine of the letters. They have no desire to know me or know Christ Jesus. So remember that these Messianic Jews, they corrupted the New Testament. And as the Samaritan woman said, "You Jews hate us." Same, these people, Jewish people, they still hate them. There was a seminar in Oxford in Wycliffe College, Wycliffe Hall, which is a theology also. And I attended that when a university professor from America, who was a Jewish, he wrote a treatise on John's Gospel, John 9, we call it, about 1200 pages or so, quite thick book. And when I asked him the question, does he know the Samaritan woman at the well? Was she a good woman or a bad one? "Oh, she was a bad woman," he tells me. He had no idea that she was known as Saint Fortina. A Russian, bishop, he put an article on her in their thing. And when I read it, I was very pleased, because in 1982, I wrote an article on the five husbands of this Samaritan woman and took it to the local church to show him, where I went earlier, and they were very pleased to give me leaflets, pamphlets on Gospels. So when I took that one, he wasn't happy. "They are not mentioned there. How can you find the names of those five husbands? She was a bad woman," and all that he was talking. Then I said, "Let me take it to London, to Westminster Cathedral." So I went there, showed to the priest there, who was a Catholic. "There's no mention of those names. Where can you get it?" So he also was surprised and thinking that I'm a madman. So I could see, their expression. And in Jesus, we preach with authority. We are not deterred by their looks or by their discouragement. We always have the backing of our Father. So we never be discouraged. So this is the situation, and it was quite interesting to meet these men of letters, and I have sent to them my article on the virgin birth of Jesus and hope it will make some impact. So I just live 30 miles away from Oxford and can catch the bus to there free, you know. It's because I'm old, over 65. I will write to the presenters of papers telling them the proofs of the virgin birth of Jesus. Such professors address Jesus as Jesus Christ. You know, they don't know the difference between title Christ and Jesus is the name. So, knowing not that the Christ is the title like a university professor, and Jesus was his personal name as mine is Rajinder Nijjar. So, these people, you know, they just vomit out whatever they like without thinking, without understanding. Even to one of their professor, I asked him, who died on the cross, Jesus or Christ? He said, oh, as my personal opinion, I would say Christ is a title, never born, never die. And but people, you know, they say in the Nicene Creed and other, Christ died, Christ rose on third day and all that, you know. So he wasn't definite, you know, what to say. So such is the nature of our Christ in our heart, that we preach gospel with authority. So let's carry on with our work. And I told that professor, you know, Jesus was his personal name as mine is Rajinder Nijjar, for Jesus having no secular father. Remember, Jesus was the second Adam. He was just Jesus. His name was just Jesus, no surname. Remember that John the Baptist, he gave up his surname because he went to wilderness. Wilderness is the place where people who have renounced the secular who have renounced the secular identity, they take to that one. In India, you know, those sadhus and other people, when they become sadhus, they do not carry their tribal identity anymore or their surname or anything. They just are known as with one name, like Sadhu Sundar or Sadhu Mahinder or so and so, no surname. Same as Christ Jesus. So he was Christ Jesus with no surname. So Christ Jesus was without a surname, mean that he was, his father was not a secular father. Secular fathers have tribal surnames. So Jesus was the second anointed Adam, and that's why when John, he went to the John the Baptist, John the Baptist was working for the Adam. When John the Baptist identified him, because he had the knowledge of the oral Torah. Oral Torah knowledge made him Prophet Elijah. Remember, the oral Torah is his word. So that's why in the royal kingdom of God, least is greater than John the Baptist. So if we are greater than John the Baptist, we do not need the Old Testament or the Jewish leaven. So these Messianic Jews, they bring in the Jewish leaven into the churches. With them there came the old customers, fulfilling the saying of Jesus, Matthew 12:43-45, that the house became worse than before. So these created popes and other thing, and they made the situation far, far worse than it was under temple rabbis. So our Father God bless